All right, hi students. This is the part where I want to show you how to do some statistical stuff on the calculator, finding our one variable stats. And I want to talk to you basically about, first of all, how to find the one variable stats for a set of data. And then also, once you've found them, you get a ton of information in that window. So we want to talk about what is it that everything in the window is showing you. And just to tell you a little bit about how this is set up, this is a TI-84 Plus emulator here. So you'll see the calculator on the left-hand side, and the last button that I clicked, I actually cleared some stuff off the screen. The last button that I clicked will be shown in red, and you can follow the buttons that I'm clicking by watching the mouse. Over here, it'll actually show you either, depending on what I want to show, a key press history. So that'll show you the buttons that I've been pressing if you want to follow along with the button presses. And I'm actually going to clear that out because we don't need to see that I just press clear. The other thing that I can show you is an enhancement of this screen. So this screen is kind of small. I can do a large version so that you can see it a little bit better. Okay. So let us start by pressing stat. And then we want to enter in some data, so let's press enter when edit is highlighted, or you can press the number 1 there. And that'll take us into our lists menu. So right now you can see here we are in our lists. And I'm just going to enter in some silly data. So actually, why don't I enter in the data from the example that we did? That way we can verify our by hand computations that we used. So the by hand set of data that we used, we had a 1. So let's go ahead and put in a 1, and then we had an 8, 2 12s, 17, and then we had a 25. So there's all of our pieces of data. Okay. Then what we want to do, if we want to compute the one variable stats, and one variable stats in your calculator will give you the mean, it'll give you the median, it'll give you both the sample and the population standard deviation, and it'll give you a bunch of other stuff. So I'll kind of show you all of what it'll give you. But this is where you want to go when you want to compute values from your set of data. So if I press stat again, and this time, well, look at our key press history. So we just pressed stat. Okay, and so we're at this menu. If I want to calculate something rather than edit, I want to press the right arrow key to navigate over to the calculate submenu. And the thing that I want to select is one variable stats. It's my first option. I can select that either by pressing enter or by pressing the number 1. And when you press enter on your main screen, it'll show you that you've selected the command one variable stats. And then it has this blinking cursor because it needs to know what list your data are in. If your data are in list 1, you can just press enter right now. That's the default. If your data are in any list other than L1, you're going to need to tell the calculator that by pressing, for example, if your data were in list 3, you would press second 3 to get your L3 to pop up like so. And this will find one variable stats for L3. But if your data are in, whoops, let me get that back up here. If your data are in list 1, you can just press enter right now, and it'll give you your set of one variable stats. And you'll notice there's a down arrow key here. If I press the down arrow key, I can scroll down to see there's a lot more data down there. Okay, so let's go through what we've got here. First of all, here's our X bar, that's the mean, tells us we have a mean of 12.5, that's what we found when we were doing the example by hand, so that's good. And notice that the calculator only uses one value here, it's using the sample symbol, since the sample is far more frequently used than the population. But if this were population data, we would want to change this when we wrote down the value to mu instead of X bar. Then we have the sum of all the x values. So if we need to know the total, there it is. This you would really only use if you were going to be using the computing formulas for standard deviation by hand. This is the sum of all the squares of your x values. We almost never need that. These two, s sub x and sigma sub x, those are your standard deviation values. S sub x is the sample standard deviation. It's about 8.12. But we were treating this data when we came up with it by hand as population data, which is the sigma sub x, and that's a value of about 7.41, which is the exact same thing as we got doing it by hand. Okay. The n here, n equals 6, that tells us we had 6 pieces of data. And then if we scroll down, there's even more. Okay, this is as far down as we can go. It gives us the minimum value of our data set, which was 1. Gives us the maximum value of our data set 2, which was 25. Also gives us the median, which is 12, in case we needed to know that. The Q1 and the Q3, we're actually not going to talk about until the next section. So for right now, you can ignore them, but know that when we need them later, this is where they come from. Okay. Biggest things to be aware of that your calculator does not find you, it doesn't find you the mode, but usually the mode is pretty easy for you to look at the data and see what's the most often occurring value. In our case, it's 12. It also doesn't give you the variance, right? We have S sub x, we have sigma sub x, but we don't have S sub x squared and sigma sub x squared. If you need to get, let me clear my key press history here. If you need to get those values, what you would do is you would take your value from your standard deviation. In our case, it was 7.41 about. So we would put in our 7.41, and we would just have to square it manually. And so our variance was approximately 54.90. This was the thing where before we square rooted it, it was 54.916666 repeating. But basically, that's how you get your variance from here. The calculator doesn't give you the variance automatically because we almost never do anything with the variance. Usually, we're using standard deviation. But just to recap, let me clear this off of here and show you the key press history again. To find our one variable stats, once we've entered the data, we press stat. We scroll over one to calc. We press enter to select one variable stats. And then from here, you would just tell your calculator where the data are stored. If they're in L1, you can just press enter, and there's your one variable stats.